Okay, I'm back with part two of the 2005 Bentley Continental GT infotainment center for the navigation. So I've removed the 2010 head unit. I've installed the 2005 head unit. And as you can see, it's playing a CD, and now it has DSP instead of NAIM. It'll let you pick. Well, maybe it's not going to. It's been hanging up on me. And shutting off and restarting. Doing this a couple of times. I'm just going to keep the video going so you can see what happens. It'll come on now and try and do some stuff. The fan's blowing. Receivable stations. And start loading. Let me turn that down for the static. I'm going to turn down the blower motor. Okay, slight delay on the radio. That's weird from when you push stuff. I fixed this. It was supposed to be glued in the back, but it broke print circuit. So anyway, all right, so we're on blower motor, right? We want to go to navigation. Push the navigation button. Navigation system not available. Go back to, say, phone. Phone is loading the phone book. Okay. Audio. There's all the stations. If I go to map, navigation system not available. You see it's lit up over there. It's going. It's plugged in. Everything's plugged in the back. But this is a 2005 head unit with a 2010 DVD disk drive. They do not match. The software in this head unit will not pair with that unit over there. And one thing I'm going to try real quick while we're doing this, I'm going to eject the disc. This is the DVD ROM I took out. Even though this is a DVD player, I'm going to insert the CD-ROM into the nav disc and see what it does. Because on the 2010, when this comes up, it'll say, please insert DVD or CD navigation disk. So let's see what happens here. It's restarting. Blower motor's back on. Volume's up. Audio. Turn down the blower motor. CD. It's playing. Let's go navvy. Navigation not available. Trip. Trip's there. Map. Navigation not available. Trip. Info. Navigation not available. Anything to do with navigation, which is the info button, the map button, the nav button, nothing will work on this 2005 unit with the 2010 disk drive. Okay. That should conclude my video, and I hope you all enjoy it. I'm going to put it back together with the 2010. All right.